Here we will show you how to change the firmware of Tuya smart ceiling lamp in order to free it from the cloud and pair with Home Assistant. The lamp presented here offers a wide variety of colors and can be used in both RGB and CCT modes. Let's start the teardown process by removing the cover. You just have to slightly turn it until it's loose. As you can see, there are three types of LEDs inside. There are warm white LEDs marked with W, cool white LEDs marked with C, and RGB LEDs, which are numbered. First is marked with 1, second with 2, and so on. There is also a LED controller in the center. Let's unscrew the cover. Do not lose the screws, you will need them later. We can't remove the controller cover yet. The wires also have to be disconnected from the terminal first. Here is the LED controller. As you can see, it's using CB2S Wi-Fi module. CB2S Wi-Fi module is based on BK7231N microcontroller and can be easily flashed with OpenBeken. Let's remove the board. A quick look at the board can already tell us which PWM IOs of Wi-Fi module are used. We still don't know which PWM is which color channel, but that can be always figured out with some guessing. It's time to program the CB2S. Let's start with desoldering the module. Add some flux to the pads, otherwise it would be very hard to melt the PB3 solder and you could even damage the pads that way. Then remove the solder with soldering weak wire. Be patient, let the solder melt. First from one side, then the second side. As you can see, the Wi-Fi module is already loose. And now the Wi-Fi module has fallen off the board. Now you can solder the programmer wires to CB2S pads. Start by adding flux to the module pad. Then add some PB solder to the pad. Also remember to thin the wires first. And finally, solder the wire to the pad. Repeat the same process for each wire. As you can see, it's very easy. Just remember to wait for solder to solidify while holding the wire. Okay, now you just need a USB to UART converter working on 3.3 voltage levels. The full flashing circuit is now shown on the screen. In this case, the jumper between VDD and 3.3 volt selects the voltage level. The 5 volt for LDO regulator is taken directly from USB 5 volt rail. In the past, we have used hide download PI to flash BK7231N. Now there is a new UI tool which can be downloaded from GitHub. Get BK7231 Simple UI Flasher and run it. Remember to select correct platform, BK7231T or N. Use the automatic latest firmware downloader to get most up-to-date firmware version. Press to backup and write, and then, while the program is waiting for getting bus, reconnect the power to Wi-Fi module. Reconnecting power can be tricky. You need to do it quickly. Timing is crucial. BK7231 UI tool will then start first doing a backup process, then it will erase the memory, and then write the OBK to the flash. After that, please configure OBK just like Tasmota. Connect to access point, set your Wi-Fi data, and make sure that new device connects to your router. it's time to put the device back together. Desolder wires from Wi-Fi module. Clear the pads so it can fit to the board again. Put Wi-Fi module in its place, add some flux and solder first pad. It's tricky to solder pads that are 90 degrees next to each other, but it is still possible. Of course, it's easier if you don't have a camera in front of you. Try to apply the solder to the pads. Do not aim it at the soldering iron tip. Pads must be clear for these methods to work. Finally, almost all pads are soldered. It's time to clear the PCB now and put it back in its place. Connect the power so you can run the device. Now you should set the I/O configuration for your device. You can do it in OpenBeken web panel. Go to Options, Configure Device. Set the 5 PWM pins required for RGB/CW channels. If you don't know which PWM is which channel, try checking each roll one by one. Finally, it's time for a final test. Is everything correct? The RGB colors control and brightness control are working. Let's check temperature control. It seems that one more thing is missing. The temperature mode is not working correctly. This is because this particular device is using an alternate temperature control. The default temperature control assumes that you have two PWM channels where first controls cool color and second controls warm color. The alternate temperature control assumes that you have two PWM channels where first controls the temperature and second controls the brightness. You can set it in OBK flags. If there is still some kind of issue, for example the cool and warm channels are swapped, you can always change the PWM role to PWM with N suffix. This is an inversed PWM. Okay, it seems that everything is correct and lamp works finally well. You can also use Options, then Home Assistant page to connect to Home Assistant by automatic discovery or by generated YAML code. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please visit our forums. You can also visit our device template database, where you can also submit a new device if you want. See you on Electroda!